Welcome back, everybody. We are here with the Squadcast crew talking all that good stuff. We're going to be talking more about some rumors that are floating out there. Caboose, I feel like you should really talk about this one in particular because you're really excited about it.
Yes. Okay. So the thing that I should preface all of this with is that you should take it with a massive grain of salt. None of this comes from it. I don't want to say it comes from an unreliable source because the person who is reporting this has been right about stuff before and has been right about some pretty big ticket items. However, they've also been wrong. So I don't want everyone to buy into this and think like, oh, it's confirmed, it's happening. But a Twitter user by the name of Daniel Richman, who some people may know on Twitter as Daniel RPK, is reporting on his Patreon, which I just find absurd that people pay for his Patreon to get scoops. but was reporting on his Patreon that NetherRealm Studios, the guys behind Mortal Kombat, behind the Injustice games, is developing a Marvel fighting game. Apparently it's in very early production. Like it maybe just got the green light and they're starting to work on it now. But then again, I don't know if that's the case because Ed Boon has been pretty much on the record saying that NetherRealm is working on whatever they got next and it's in its early stages. And he said that a little while ago. So I don't know how early into production it is, but if this is true, right, if this is happening, we're probably not going to know about it for at least, I'd say, like a year, maybe two. And I guess just the question is, because this is all like heavy, heavy rumor. The question for you guys is not whether or not you think it's happening, but does this even excite you? Would you want to see NetherRealm make a Marvel fighting game? Because for me, that's extremely exciting. As much as I love Marvel versus Capcom, I am down for just a straight up Marvel fighting game from NetherRealm and then maybe even doing like a story mode the way that they did with Mortal Kombat 11 and Injustice 2. Like, I would love to see them playing in the Marvel sandbox.
Yeah. I mean,
go ahead, Camille.
We're both excited about this.
We're both ready.
You go, Malik.
Oh, well, you know, I mean, you bag on Camille a lot, and I'm going to have to dish it back. Are you excited for a good Avengers game now? Are we finally going to get a good Avengers game?
I mean, yeah, here's hoping. Jesus.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
I am excited for this. Like, it cuts deep. I'm just excited. Like, this is exciting. Like, Injustice was a good treatment for DC, and the fact that there was a follow-up to it that was just as successful. I think this only spells good things for a game of this nature, especially coming from NetherRealm. I mean, come on.
Yeah. I feel like if there's any studio to put a good story behind Marvel characters in a fighting game form, it is definitely NetherRealm. Like, you wouldn't want anyone else to do it. They're just excellent. Since they did like that reboot of Mortal Kombat, they really are laying out that story and that lore and how you could play through the cinematics, which I would be really interested to see. And that's what makes me excited. And I think Ed Boon even mentioned like years ago that he talked to Marvel about possibly, you know, doing a fighting game, but he didn't really give us anything more than that. And he said it would be cool if Marvel versus like DC, right?
Which, yeah, and it looked like, when he talked about that, he was like, oh boy, I shouldn't have said that.
Yeah.
You know?
It did. And, like, I think that would be the coolest thing, you know, that Marvel and DC fans, we don't really get a lot of. Marvel versus DC, NetherRealm would make perfect sense for that. My only hesitation is when I think of Marvel and when I think of fighting games, I instantly think Marvel versus Capcom. And I think of that type of game for Marvel characters because that's what I grew up with. And I think they fit perfectly in terms of how they move, how the animation works, except for Marvel Infinite, which I'm going to show a little bit of. But I think mostly Marvel versus Capcom is where I would want to see fighting. Fighting game, the combat element of a Marvel character. However, you know, I feel like we could just adjust. If we're getting a good story, if we're getting, if it is Marvel versus DC, this is something that a lot of fans have not seen in a fighting game before or in a game before, that would be really cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And playing devil's advocate and just saying, okay, maybe this is happening. I mean, this is just continuing that trend of seeing Marvel just play to its strongest suit and seeking out the best talent for the right game. I mean, look at what they've done with Insomniac Games with Spider-Man. That was even before the acquisition. So without getting Sony involved that heavily, Insomniac Game, really great with traversal, really great with action. Spider-Man was perfect. Same with Camouflage and Iron Man VR, playing to that studio's strengths. If Marvel is trying to look at different studios and saying, okay, we want a fighting game, we want to get into that sector and do a proper story as well, I can't think of a better studio than NetherRealm for that. And I think that even if you're looking at, okay, well, we could tap back into Capcom, their stories just weren't that great, in my opinion. I mean, there were some great beats and everything, but if you're looking at like a well-established package and you just want it to be Marvel, just Marvel characters, go to NetherRealm.
Yeah,
they know how to give that game the treatment.
Well, here's another question that I pose to you guys, and this is part of the reason why I'm of the opinion that I don't think this is going to happen. Right. Is that
like Marvel, you know, game, granted, or Marvel versus DC? Like a Marvel game. Well,
to be honest, I think Marvel versus DC is like, that's the pipe dream, and I would love to see it, but I don't think that we'll ever see it. Although maybe I shouldn't say never, because there's always a chance. Mm-hmm. But in terms of just a Marvel fighting game, right? Just there, I see that as an unlikely possibility, simply because it would be WB Games publishing the game.
What about TT?
I know that that's the counter, but I always see that, and maybe people would disagree with me, but I always see LEGO games to just kind of be that step below. You know, they don't reach that AAA status. LEGO games are always really like, let's just throw a game together for people to play and have some enjoyment out of. This would be something that I would see as like a big deal, a full AAA title that has a lot of support put into it, a lot of money put into it, and that would have to be a massive partnership between Marvel and WB Games. So do you guys see it that as playing a factor, or do you think because of those LEGO games, this will be an easy partnership?
I think
it'll be, oh, go ahead, Kevin.
Yeah, I if Malik was gonna say what I was gonna say, if they agree with you, I think it will be okay, just because of how, especially because of how Avengers performed.
Yeah.
I think that would make the case. I think
that's fair.
You know, when we look at the movies are completely different when they're selling a movie, but when they're trying to get into games and they know they don't have that market, like, I don't know, the Arkham games do, or like Injustice does, it makes perfect sense. You want to get in with WB on the gaming side of things, because you already have that relationship. I would disagree with you. I think, you know, it's not AAA, you know, standard, but they sell like AAA because of the demographic. So that's why I would disagree with you. I think they already have that relationship there. Why not go further, especially now that you're seeing what they're doing with Gotham Knights and how they're expanding? It makes perfect sense. They've tried other publishers. It did not work. Go to the people who make, like Steve said, you seek the greatest of that medium, and that is NetherRealm, and that is WB.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that's fair.
Yeah, and I hate to continue to like harp on this topic, but like at the end of the day, they're going to look at who can make the best game and get us the most profits. And I think that money speaks more than people think it can, and I think that they can set aside whatever differences or, you know, technicalities that might be in there. I think this is also like a way different subject matter than saying like WB on the film side versus the game side. I think, you know, like they can kind of just say, okay, well, you guys are just handling games. You guys aren't competing. It's not like NetherRealm is releasing Injustice at the same time. This is going to be like two separate projects for them. So I could see it there. I still think it's a crazy rumor. I don't really believe it.
I think if
it's probably because it was hidden behind a paywall. Come on.
Oh yeah. I think if we get anything, Camille, because you had mentioned X-Men or Marvel versus DC, I think if we get anything, it's X-Men versus Avengers. I think Disney and Marvel owns, you know, the X-Men. I'm really hoping, here's my one thing. I pray to God that Spider-Man as a character is not locked to PlayStation. Please don't do that. Please don't do that. It's an easy, that is such an easy DLC bait for them to have. Just don't do it. But like you're saying, I know they're probably going to, but it's just, I think that this could be amazing. It could also be, because I mean, let's admit, Mortal Kombat and Injustice both are pretty dark fighting games. Like, they have very dark, mature themes. This mm-hmm. could be a way for them to reach to a larger and maybe younger audience while hitting on something that's already incredibly popular and already has some deep storylines going, and possibly just expanding. But it, like you said, Caboose, this is at least 2 years out.
That's interesting that you mentioned that, though, because I never really... I know, obviously, Marvel usually is a bit lighter than DC, especially when we're seeing it in the game realm of things. How would a Marvel NetherRealm game look like? Do we want it to be bloody? Do we want it to be as gruesome as Mortal Kombat? Would we actually see that?
I want to see Captain America fatalities.
Yeah. Yeah, give me John Walker decapitating someone.
Yes.
Yeah, no, I mean, I don't know if I would want to see it to that level, but even like the Injustice games are pretty mature in their themes and everything, and I wouldn't mind that. That's also what is so good about those games, is that they kind of push the boundaries. They're not rated M. Mm-hmm. They're not like fully violent to the point where you're like, dear Lord. But like Superman becomes like a tyrant. He becomes like this dictator of the world. He sticks his hand through Joker's chest to kill him. Like, there's some pretty adult things that happen. And I think part of that as well comes from DC as a brand starting to push towards that direction. Mm-hmm. Like, they still have stuff for their younger audiences. But I think if Mortal Kombat versus DC happened today, it would be very good. Like, it could actually be a super legit game.
Yeah.
Because fatalities and everything would be in there. And I think that they would be pushed to their limits, you know, pushed to the full potential of Mortal Kombat. But you know, with a Marvel brand, they may not be down for that. Maybe they'd be okay with the game being a bit more mature, because you look at like Insomniac Spider-Man or even Spider-Man Miles Morales or even the Avengers storyline, and they aren't necessarily like for children, you know. Mm-hmm. they're a little more adult. They have some more mature themes to them too, so I could see NetherRealm being able to tell the story that they would want to, without maybe not necessarily pushing some of the boundaries that they did with Injustice.
Us just talking like this, I think I realized I don't want just any Marvel fighting game now. I really do just want that Marvel versus DC. If NetherRealm is doing a Marvel fighting game, I do not want NetherRealm to do a Marvel fighting game just alone.
Okay.
Just because of that issue with theme. Just because, okay, I can't picture NetherRealm doing something different.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like if it's just a Marvel fighting game, it would have to be different. What made Marvel versus Capcom, like the originals, so interesting is the fact that it was cheesy. You had those one-liners. They played into that, right? And I would want to see that for a Marvel proper fighting game. If it is Marvel versus DC, I could understand the shift in tone. I could understand why that would work better on screen, the look of the characters. Like, when you look at DC characters, they're much more rugged, they're much more dark. Marvel characters are very colorful. Marvel versus Capcom pops off the screen. Mm-hmm. I would want to see that in a Marvel fighting game, but if it's Marvel versus DC, I could understand if they tone it down.
That's fair.
Yeah.
I think that's a good point.
I'm going to stick with that. Thank you. all right. Well, we'll just have to see if these rumors are true, which I agree with you, Caboose. Probably not. Not going to happen. But we could always dream, can't we?
That's right.
Here's hope.
We can dream.